A global investment banker flags several problematic aspects of the proposed Maharlika Investment Fund. Stephen Kun Ying says, aside from the IMF or MIF having no clear-cut purpose, it also does not know what it is going to invest in. He also warned sourcing seed money from the Land Bank and the Development Bank of the Philippines also has an impact on the bank's lending capability.
Land Bank is going to put in 50 billion pesos. DBP is supposed to put in 25 billion pesos. That is very critical because in a bank, you normally have about 10% tier one capital. What does that mean? And this is the problem when you don't carefully study the implications of your provisions. That means you reduce the Land Bank's borrowing capacity by 500 billion pesos, not 50. And you reduce the DBP's lending capacity, not by 25 billion, but 250 billion. So now you have reduced their ability to lend to the agricultural center, to lend to infrastructure.
The growth in Philippine manufacturing output continues in April. Data from the Statistics Bureau show the volume of production index expanded by 8.2% in April. That's higher than the 3.4% in March and last year's 1.3% contraction. It is also the highest in 3 months. The PSA attributed this to the expansion in three sectors: food products, transport equipment, and other non-metallic minerals. Meanwhile, a BMI economist predicts the Philippines' manufacturing goods will shoot up nearly 120% this year compared to 2015. But he warns many emerging markets will have slower growth this year, and inflation, though slowing, will remain elevated.
That integration of these economies into global manufacturing supply chains has really boosted wages. It's the way that the previous wave, we could say, of Asian economies that successfully raised themselves up to high income status. If we look at Singapore or Taiwan or South Korea and Japan years before, this is the path that they followed. Right? They linked into manufacturing supply chains, they boosted the skills of their workforce, and they found a niche.
Two major e-commerce companies are told by the Philippine Trade Department to explain alleged fake products in their platforms. Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual said Thursday they received reports of scammers selling defective and pirated products on the platforms which he did not identify. Pascual says the companies were given 72 hours to submit an explanation. Now, he also warns the sale of fraudulent goods violates the country's e-commerce law. The Philippine Energy Chief calling on the World Bank to provide more funding for energy transition projects. Secretary Rafael Lotilla spoke Thursday at a forum organized by the multilateral lender. He says while the Philippines is thankful for the World Bank's support, it needs more help in transitioning to cleaner sources of energy. Lotilla adds Manila is yet to be included in the World Bank's energy transition program, meant to help countries become less dependent on coal.
In the case of the Philippines, with reform, its power industry, 20 years ago, by privatization and by unbundling, unfortunately, we are not part of any of the just energy transition partnerships that have already been put in place. The time for investing in transmission is now, and this is an ongoing conversation that we have with the World Bank and with the Asian Development Bank, and I hope that they will catch up with us.
Let's now zip through top corporate stories at this hour. Property giant Ayala Land's long-term bond program worth as much as 50 billion pesos has been approved by Philippine regulators. Ayala Land plans to raise 12 billion pesos through the bond sale in the first tranche of the program. This may increase by another 5 billion pesos if the oversubscription option is taken. Now, the company's bond offer will be up for sale from June 14 to 20. For business tycoon Enrique Razon, his power distribution company More Power will spend 4 billion pesos to modernize Bacolod City-based company Central Negros Electric Cooperative or CENECO. More Power said 2 billion of that will be used to purchase assets for its joint venture agreement, while another 2 billion will be used as capital. And finally, principal shareholders of LMG Chemicals Corporation will share their stake in the firm to Max Wealth Infinity. The key owners will sell their combined 67% stake. Max Wealth will get about 129 million common shares, which are priced at around 3 pesos apiece.